Hello. My name is Smokey Bear.
First time I ever heard the name Smokey the Bear was from some park rangers that came to my kindergarten class to give a presentation. We saw a film strip about him and how to make sure your fires are put out when you're out camping. And I remember the next time we went on a trip, I was telling my dad step by step what to do to make sure that our fire was out. Like millions of other people, Smokey the Bear was a big influence in my life. And after all these years, I never knew that he was from New Mexico. So I asked Ranger Larry Paul to tell me the story of Smokey the Bear.
The first thing I would say, though, is Smokey Bear. It's not Santa the Claus. It's Smokey Bear. Smokey the Bear actually came from a song written in the early 40s.
With a ranger's hat and shovel and a pair of dungarees, you will find him in the forest, always sniffing at the breeze. People stop and pay attention when he tells them to beware.
They added the in the song, and it stuck. But it's actually Smokey Bear.
Smokey the Bear.
Smokey the Bear.
Prowling and a growling and a sniffing the air. He can find a fire before it starts to flame. That's why they call him Smokey. That was how he got his name.
Prior to adopting Smokey Bear as the symbol, they used other animals. Anything like, you know, like the Bambi movie, you know, all the little rabbits and the birds. And they used whatever they thought would grab people's attention. And when they found the cub, it fit. The image of Smokey Bear with the shovel or putting out the fire is literally recognized worldwide. Subsequent to the Smokey Bear program that was started in 1940, a wildfire in the Capitan Mountains of New Mexico. During that fire, they found a bear cub badly burned, clinging to a tree. The bear would not have survived, and had they not brought it in, it would have perished. There's no doubt about it. They called it Hotfoot Teddy because it had been burned and its paws had been burned and hair had been burned. That didn't last real long. They decided to give it the name Smokey Bear to go along with the Smokey Bear anti-fire or fire prevention program. They transferred the cub to Santa Fe to a veterinarian, Dr. Bell. Dr. Bell looked at the bear and was patching it up. His daughter, Judy Bell, they took a picture of the bear and Judy, and that's become a very famous photograph, and it's called Cub and Cub. It's a favorite of mine, and it's a favorite of most people, I think. Smokey Bear healed up, and it was eventually adopted by the Washington Zoo. And I remember as a child, before I was even in school, that some of my playmates had gone to Washington, D.C., and actually saw Smokey the Bear. And that was a big deal to us, little kids. I'm sure it made a lot of impressions on a lot of kids. Everybody, young and old, says hi to Smokey, wants to wave at Smokey, wants their picture made with Smokey Bear. That's a good thing, and that's a wonderful thing. And that it spread the word. Only you can prevent wildfires, and it's true.
Only you can prevent wildfires.
It's easy to remember, it's catchy, and people love it. And so it's very successful. And I think it resonates with people that we can do a better job if we all work together. And I think it tells a story. Smokey Bear died in 1976. It was brought back and is buried in Capitan, New Mexico. And that's pretty much where the Smokey Bear story stops. There's been other Smokey Bears, I think, but none of them have been the original. That's the original Smokey Bear.
If you've ever seen the forest when a fire was running wild, and you love the things within it like a mother loves her child, then you know why Smokey tells you when he sees you pass.
If I hear the song, remember, I'll probably be humming it all day long.
How does it go? Just a little bit.
Smokey the Bear, Smokey the Bear. romping and stomping and sniffing the air, you know.
He can find a fire before it starts to flame. That's why they call him Smokey. That was how he got his name.